Bismita, we are going to be talking about sexually transmitted infection.
Theodora, that's going to make people uncomfortable.
I agree. People are rolling their eyes now. But hold on, this is very important.
All right, what are we talking about?
Syphilis.
We're going to talk about syphilis today. So, Theodora, last time I heard about syphilis was in some movie, I think Out of Africa. Didn't Alexander the Great have syphilis? I thought we had this under control.
Syphilis is an ancient disease. In the earlier days, people die of syphilis, and it's incurable. But now, because of the discovery of benzotine penicillin, syphilis rates are going down in the 1940s, but it's rising again.
All right, so why should we be concerned about syphilis?
We should be concerned. Syphilis is increasing. Now we have about 8 million syphilis cases this year. And also you will note that syphilis is increasing in pregnant women, affecting their unborn and newborn children. And most importantly, this can result into stillbirths, prematurity, newborn infections that are going to be there for a long time.
So we don't always think about a disease like syphilis. Talk to us about who is at risk and how do you get it?
Well, you get it from sex. Mothers can transmit it to their children. And of course, syphilis can be transmitted through blood, like in blood transfusion. If you or your partners are having multiple partners, then your likelihood of having syphilis is increased. MSM, men having sex with men, and sex workers are also disproportionately affected.
And what are the symptoms of syphilis?
Well, majority of people with syphilis do not have symptoms. Sometimes it's even unnoticed by the healthcare provider. Untreated syphilis can be there for a long time. But of course, it starts with a primary syphilis. And in primary syphilis, you have a hard chancre. It's painless. Then it spontaneously resolves. It's untreated. You go into secondary syphilis, where you have rashes, which are usually not itchy, and they're usually found in the palms and in the soles of your feet. It is accompanied by flu-like symptoms, and it's also accompanied by lesions in your genitals. This will resolve spontaneously again. Then you go into latent syphilis where you don't have any symptoms. This can take a long time. Then you go into the tertiary syphilis where it affects your brain and your nerves and also your heart. Remember that with syphilis, it's the greatest sneaky imposter disease. It can mimic any infection. But also remember that syphilis can be asymptomatic. So it's so important to get tested to know if you have syphilis.
Okay, that worries me, that you can have syphilis. It will keep having some symptoms, then it'll go away. And you can have syphilis and not know it. So when you're in that latent period, can you still infect others?
Oh, yes. During the time when you are asymptomatic, you can infect others, but you're most infectious in the primary and secondary syphilis.
Okay, so how do you prevent syphilis?
Syphilis can be prevented, of course. Prevention is key. First of all is have safer sexual practices. If you think you're risky, use a condom. Wait, I need to show you this, Bismita. This is the condom. This is so important. You should use them when you are having sex. Also, I think what's very important, because syphilis is treatable and it is curable, get tested and treated. If you have high-risk behavior or you're in the key population like MSM or sex worker, but also if you're pregnant, get screened and treated if needed. We also plead for healthcare providers to please provide respectful and discreet services. And most importantly, I think for policymakers, they need to provide us with more support on sexual health.
Those are very important points. Talk to us about why this disease is not under control.
it's not under control because culturally we are now having an increase in high-risk behavior. More people are having more multiple partners. There is increasing access to casual sex. There's decreasing condom use. And also, most importantly, other sexual safer behavior are not being practiced. Most importantly, also, there is already a decreasing access to sexual health, meaning there's limited sexual health services, but also people who have STIs or syphilis is very adamant not to go to a service because of stigma and discrimination.
Thank you, Teodora. Tell our audience, what is it that we need to do to prevent syphilis?
Prevent it by having safer sexual practice, use the condom, and test and treat.
Listen to Teodora. Stay safe. Stay healthy and stick with science.